past couple of months in quarantine, we've all been relying on technology for almost everything. I've been finding myself using my phone more and more often, and maybe you can relate. Maybe you even think it's normal given the circumstances. But I've been getting these weekly battery usage reports, and if you don't know what this is, it's basically a feature on your phone that tells you on exactly what you're spending your time. And if you haven't looked for it, I challenge you to do it now. Last week's report said I had been spending, on average, daily, 5 hours on social media. 5 hours on one day. And when I saw that, that absolutely terrified me. Without a doubt, our society is greatly impacted by social media influencers, and technology. But what do you think about when I say the word influencer? Maybe you think of your favorite YouTuber, vlogger, Instagram model, whatever it is. Without a doubt, these people greatly influence our lives. Whether it's to the favorite podcast you listen to, or the merch you're buying, or what videos you're watching, these people have some sort of impact in our lives. Now, I want to ask you one question. How is your career as an influencer going? Or do you not consider yourself an influencer? I think that is the problem right there. When we don't consider ourselves influencers, when Jesus gave us this title when he died on the cross. It is an honor, and we must assume this responsibility as Christians. When you think of influence, I think it's best to think of it in terms of what you are leaving behind on this world. Influence is the mark you leave behind, how people will remember you. How powerful to acknowledge and accept that Jesus had said over your life that you are an influencer. He said in Matthew 5, 13 and 14, you are the salt and you are light in the world. Now, the first step to assuming the responsibility and pursuing your life as an influencer is to accept the position. You are an influencer because Jesus said you are an influencer and you are the salt of the earth. After you accept this position, the next question would be, what am I influencing? What mark will I leave behind for others? Hebrews 10:24 says, let us think of ways to motivate one another to act of love and good works. This is where you can be creative with your influence. Think of ways to motivate people. Maybe it's a text, maybe it's a phone call. Encourage people, get behind them, believe in them, motivate them. Show your gratitude. Tell them the good you see in them and the good they are. Now, the second step is simple, but it can greatly change the people around you. Commit. Make this responsibility something you genuinely care about and you want to pursue. Influence the people around you. There is no better time than now to assume this great responsibility. I pray today that God will use you to be a blessing and an influence in others' lives. Make sure you tune in to TBCC Weekly for more content like this.